everybody, happy Monday. It's Monday. It's Monday. And once again, we're live. Hi, I'm Keila Fowler, founder and CEO of 85 Beauty. 85 Beauty is all about kicking intimidation to the curb and making sure that makeup feels easy and accessible. So today we're talking about interview and meeting the parents and first impressions. You know, like those moments that matter. You want to get it right and you don't want to look crazy or have somebody judging you, like prejudging you before they get to know you. You just want to make a really good first impression. So that's what we're going to do today. I'm going to let you know that that was not the original plan. I pivoted at the last moment. Originally, I was just going to do this like wild, fun, intense blue eyeshadow makeup just to like have a great time. And then I thought, well, that's not easy or accessible. So I thought I'd give you this instead. But if you want that, let me know. And I'll totally show you the like get down with the blue, because it's great. I'm just gonna let you know that right now. So as always, I'm gonna take a moment, share this out, make sure everybody who needs to see it can see it. I am also gonna take like a real nice gulp of my iced tea. Y'all, the season is upon us. I'm just saying, it's been here for a while, but I have held off because I make my iced tea like my grandma and my mom, which means it has a lot of sugar, it's a lot, and a lot of lemon juice, and it's dang delicious. It is so good. It's the most delicious. It's so yummy, but it's also a lot of sugar. And so it's not something that I drink very often. I've been drinking a lot of water and a lot of sparkling water. I'm getting off of drinking soda. I don't remember the last time I had a soda, which is great, but I made a pitcher. And I'm the only one who lives here, so it goes, you realize how much of something you drink when you're the only person at home drinking it. And I was like, it's so yummy. And the like line on the pitcher gets lower and lower, so but it's good. Oh my gosh, it's so good. So if you have not had homemade iced tea in a while, like get on it. It's especially as hot as it's been. Y'all, I live on the East Coast. I'm in Pennsylvania. It's been hot, like hot recently. And I don't like to sweat. Like yesterday was just one of those, not yesterday, the days have blended together. 4th of July, it was a scorcher. And my sister-in-law and I were like, we don't like being hot. This isn't enjoyable. Why are we doing this? And every time we'd walk inside, we're like, oh, air conditioning. Thank God. It feels so much better. So just, you know, iced tea makes it all better. But you also ingest a lot of sugar. So just, all right, I'm just letting you know. That's a thing. Okay. Let's start with what you're looking for when it comes to first impressions. I find that if you can try to look as much like the version of yourself that's in your head as possible, the better. So it's similar to how, like, okay, let's take a moment. Everyone has this idea in their head of what they want to look like. The hardest part is communicating that. And the other part of it that's, my house is at a comfortable 60 degrees. Bless you. And bravo. The second part that's really hard though is creating that look if you're not sure if you're not sure what that looks like. Like you know what I'm saying? Like you have it in your head, but then when you go to do it, it doesn't always end up looking the way you want it to. You know what I'm saying? Like that's such a frustrating thing that can happen sometimes. So I'm going to tell you first what that vision is in my head. And then I will show you how to make it come to life, because that is something that is really important, is first being able to communicate it, and second being able to make it happen. So first thing, I know that I want my skin to look very balanced and blemish free. I'm going to tell you, this is just so true. If you've ever had any kind of skin issue, like in the back of your head, and let me know if this is real for you in the comments. In the back of your head, you're always thinking about the way your skin used to look, but not the way that it looks currently. And so you're kind of having to catch up to the current view of what you look like. So I had acne in middle school, and I still get breakouts from time to time, especially with masks. We're going to be talking about that. I promise we're going to do a video because it's been requested. I personally need it. And the mask situation has been jacking up my face. My skin is like, I hate this. And I'm like, so do I. Could you stop? Meaning, can my skin stop reacting? Not can we stop wearing masks? Like, can we just please wear a mask? Just wear a mask. I don't want to ever look like my skin is having a problem. So it's super important to me that I have really balanced, good looking skin. So that means I want to make sure that I'm wearing concealer and foundation that isn't going to make me look greasy and that isn't going to show a lot of texture, which means I don't want any shimmer. So that helps me decide. I've shown you sometimes that you can kind of like mix in an oil or use a dewy foundation, especially if you are on the drier skin side. I am not, but I do that from time to time for a specific look. I don't want that though. So I'm gonna start there and I'm gonna mix foundation. I do this all the time. I told you last week or the week prior that you need to start doing this. So I have two of the exact same foundations, clearly. One is lighter, one is darker, because I have been out in the sun and I'm starting to get darker. I'm not as dark as I will be towards the end of summer, so I can't just wear this one on its own. I need to mix them. And I have found, because I'm like a mad scientist when it comes to makeup, that mixing in a little bit of this, because this has a lot more yellow in it, gets me like the exact color I'm going for. That is just where I'm at right now. This doesn't mean something that you have to do, but I like to tell you all of the in-between steps that they typically, the infamous they, typically don't tell you, and then you wonder why you don't get the same results, because people lie. I'm just letting you know. They omit things that make it, that help you understand. So, because I want my skin to look not like I, words. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm struggling. I am going to start with my foundation. I know that I am going to use I'm going to have like a really clean but put together eye look. If you're going to do a smoky eye or any kind of intense eye, especially if you're going to do anything with glitter, don't use glitter. This is not the time for glitter. But if you were, then you would want to do your eyes first. That way, anything that falls down, you can clean it up without messing up the work that you've done. Because I'm not doing anything really intense with the eyes, I can go ahead and do my foundation first, get a really nice clean canvas, and then build from there. So I am using a beauty blender, and I'm just tapping my foundation all over. Now, I've shown you before, you can absolutely just use foundation or just concealer in the areas that you need it. That's up to you. I like to do a full face of foundation whenever I have a first impression, because I much prefer having one clean canvas and then building in the dimension that I like and that I prefer, than to worry that I didn't blend in my concealer well enough in this area or that area. So that's why I am choosing to do foundation first and then add in concealer and bronzer and blush and all those other things later. Okay, so you want to get it on there. And I normally use just like the roundest part for foundation, but then you can use any of the other sides just to press in the product without adding any more onto your skin. What this is gonna do is that it just kind of helps to blend everything so that you don't have any really harsh lines showing where maybe you forgot, you like maybe missed an area. So you can just slide to a cleaner area on your sponge just to make sure everything blends in. So we're getting the skin all worked out. Excellent. Now, next thing that I know I want to do is for this look, right? What I'm going for, I don't want any dark circles under my eyes because, well, y'all, I love to sleep. I love sleep so much. And I also just naturally have a little darkness here. And there's something about a really good concealer. Actually, I don't want to use this one today. I want, my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. I've been all over that recently. It just gives like a little bit more brightness. And then I like to add just a hint of the Catrice Liquid Camouflage. It's a little bit brighter. You see how like it's a tiny bit lighter? And I like how that just kind of boosts things up a little bit. I can use a brush or I can use my sponge. I'm just gonna use my sponge. I like to tap from the outside in just to make sure that this lighter color isn't going out too far. And then I can control the placement a little bit better. And then from the inside out on the eyelid. Notice I flip my sponge around. And if you find that you need to add a little bit more in an area, you can do that. So once I have my base, so to speak, all taken care of, I will be able to start building in more color, more dimension, etc. I'm just checking to make sure I'm not missing any comments. Looks like we're good. All right. So we have concealer looking great. Okay. Now, I get hot. I sweat. I love how people are like, women don't sweat, we glow. And I'm like, that's adorable. I sweat like a lot. It's a situation. And I've taught you, right? Like, don't just go like swiping sweat all right. You gotta pat it off, but for real, all the powder. Like the powder's gonna change the world. I do powder underneath the eyes to set my concealer, and then I always powder my nose pretty relentlessly. It's important. Also powder my eyelids because 'tis the season. If you are oily at all, this is your greasiest time of year. It just is, and it's a terrible way to be in terms of like I just spend all day looking in the mirror to see like what's happening with my face right now. Pat, 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 pat. You want to press in your powder, really kind of lock it all in there. Feel like I got something in my eye, which may have happened. Can you recommend a good powder? Why, yes, I can. Okay, so I'm using, this is the Laura Mercier translucent powder. This one's in medium deep. You can get the regular, well, like I think it's called light medium, perhaps. Sorry, there really is something in my eye. I feel it and it hurts. Hold on. I got powder in my eye. Don't ask me how. I don't know what it did, but I feel it. Oh, that's better. Laura Mercier makes a really good powder. I've heard that Huda Beauty makes a really good one. Let's see here. Oh, the Maybelline Fit Me powders are really nice, but the darker they get, they get a little ashy. But Lanice, you wouldn't have a problem with that. Yeah, those are the my top choices for powders. And then we're gonna do bronzer. I left my bronzer in the other room, I think. But I have another one. Always have another one. Okay. So if you wear foundation, you should wear some kind of other color in your cheeks, whether it is bronzer or blush. You should put something else because you look really flat. Like you've basically kind of taken all of the dimension that naturally occurs in your skin out, and you want to like bring it back to life and make it look, I won't say normal, I will say more natural. Like this is how you naturally look. I'm gonna blush a little bit differently today. I mean, bronze a little bit differently today. And I'm going to actually start at the like apple of my cheek. I normally start like back here and go under my cheek. I want my bronzer a little bit higher today. Why? Well, because this morning on Instagram, I was watching Sam Chapman. If you're familiar with Pixie Woo from YouTube, Sam and Nick are phenomenal makeup artists, and she blushed or she used her bronzer that way, and I really liked it. So now, you get inspired and then you try something new. And I do like how it has a little bit more of like a blushed effect. But yeah, when you bronze, like in the natural areas that sun would hit you, it just like your skin starts to kind of come back to life a bit. Ooh. Okay. Blush. I'm gonna use, if you haven't used these, the Flower, I think I have another one of these, but it might be in the other room. The Flower Beauty Blush Bombs. These are really fun, but I've got two of them. But you want to use them really sparingly. So this color is Bitten, this one is Melon. They're liquid blushes. And so what I like to do is I just put, that is too much. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's a lot. So I like to do that and then spread it a little bit onto my hand. And I'm gonna start with this little baby Real Techniques. They have the Real Techniques Miracle Complexion Sponge. The little like minis, they actually look like this, but then when you get them, when you dampen them, then they grow. So I'm going to use this little baby one. And I'm just going to tap this in onto my cheeks. And it's light. It isn't meant to be a really like intense bam, there's her blush. I want to look kind of ethereal. Like, wow, what a naturally gorgeous, lovely woman that is. Let's hire her. Or yeah, she can date my son. Can I though? Like for real though, I'm single, so just letting you know if you've got any cute guys out there. This is not for like okay, moving on. Mondays are weird, that's all I can say. So, a little bit of blush. Just like a hint of color. See how when I smile, you can see it like pop, come through? I will add a little, just a teeny bit more because that's way too much. Some of it is on my finger. I use a little too much. Gives a nice flush of color. Yes, that's what you want. You just want like a flush. You don't want it to look like you are embarrassed. Like you're having one of those like a shy moment or a moment where you're like, oh gosh, what have I done? You don't want it to look super obvious. And I find that sponges, when it comes to adding in any kind of liquid or cream blush, are going to give the softest effect. If you are doing any kind of video conferencing, it really helps to do your makeup with your webcam on because the color translates very differently from your mirror to your camera. So, if this is for a video conference or a video interview or a video, any kind of video interaction, make sure that you do your makeup in the camera that you're going to use on your computer. It makes a huge difference. Especially when it comes to blush, when it comes to brows and lip color. Those are three really intense areas of the face that you just want to get those things right. So speaking of brows, I want a strong brow because I'm on video. I tend to go a little heavier on my eyebrow on video than in person because in person you don't need it to like scream at you. Now on Instagram earlier, I shaped up, I tweezed my eyebrows, so they are in really good shape right now. And I need a mirror that's closer. I find that if you are having trouble, if you're having trouble filling in your eyebrows, it is quite possibly because your brows need to be shaped up. Every time that it takes me longer to do my brows, I'm like, oh, I need to tweeze. Because the more, I won't say unruly, but just unkept your brows are, the harder it is to get them to look the way you want them to. Whereas if the shape is kind of already in place, then you're just adding a little color here and there where you need it, and then bam, you're done. Like so. This brow, that was so fast. Sorry, sometimes I kind of stop talking when I'm doing brows because I concentrate. Whoopsies. I'm just looking. Do y'all have any questions? I use the same pencil every single time. This is the L'Oreal Brow Stylist. No, what is it? The Brow Stylist Definer pencil in the color Brunette. It is hard to find for whatever reason. It is always, they have other colors, but the Brunette is always out of stock, probably because it's the color that most people need to use. So I always buy them in two. When I find them, I just buy them in, oh, crud. Almost messed this up. I buy them in twos, so I always have a backup because that's the other thing. With these twist-up pencils, you never know when you're at the last little twist and then you click and nothing comes out and then you are upset if you're me. Because you're like, how? Why? I need you. Little brow gel. This Glossier Boy Brow, I don't understand how there's still so much product, but it's so small. But for real, this is like the Energizer Bunny of brows. It just works, and this is the clear. Okay, eyeshadow. Lot of people, this is where they screw it up because they get way too adventurous. Like, what are we doing? Come on, let's remember first impressions. If it's between somebody commenting on like your earrings, which by the way, these are by Emily Williams. Ooh, the light is making it hard for you to see. Let me. Oh, that's better. Do you see how they have like a hint of like blue and pink? They are so pretty. So if you are into these, they are from Emily Williams, and she's at Emily Says on Instagram. And I am just typing her into the comments so you can find her. Yeah. Let like a really beautiful earring be the point of conversation. If there's something like, oh wow, did you see, like, she also had fabulous earrings. Instead of, ooh, did you see her eyeshadow? Don't let your eyeshadow be the talking point. Not for a first impression. Once you're like in the company, or like once you've been like going to the family picnics for a year, like then, I mean, not a year, but like, just think it through. You know what I'm saying? Like, think it through. So what I prefer to do is either something like this that is in the skin tone family, right? It's not really obnoxious. It's not too dark. It's not too bright. It has a hint. It has a bit of shimmer in it. Really pretty. You can do this all over the eyelid. Something like this that has like a little bit more gold, but still it's in like the earth tone family. No, 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 no. Don't get excited. You know what I'm saying? Like keep it clean, keep it classy. So we are going to do, let's do this one. So I'm gonna use a brush as per usual, fluffy brush. I am just going to press this all over the eyelid. Don't worry, we're going to give it like a little, we're going to give it a little kick, a little dimension, nothing too intense, but a little something, right? And this is great because you can do this fast, right? Tap, 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 and then just back and forth windshield wiper motions. It's just going to drag, not drag, but like, just like encourage the eyeshadow to just naturally blend up. And it's going to stop at just the right spot because you didn't add any extra eyeshadow to the edge of the brush where you're going to do the blending. So all the color packed on the side here, when you start blending, it's just going to naturally stay concentrated on the eyelid, and all the extra is just going to like whisper its way up and blend super naturally, right? Like a whisper. See that? Like it's just like a whisper. It isn't super intense. It's actually a little bit brighter in person, and that's okay. Then you can go straight down, tap the extra always, and you can just do like a little, just a little underneath, like so. Okay. Really bright over on that side, so let's even that out. Okay, one color done. We are gonna do a little eyeliner. Are we though? Where did my eyeliner go? Ooh. Okay, so this is where I do not believe in like getting intense. A lot of people like black eyeliner. Yeah, black eyeliner. I like black eyeliner too. But this is where you can end up screwing it up. So go with something that's more of like a bronze or a brown or something just softer. So this is from Pixi and it is Copper Glow. So I'm just going to add a little bit of that right along my lashes. And it's going to define the eye and give you some dimension without it being a like, whoa, did you see that smoky eye? This is not a smoky eye moment. It is not a smoky eye moment. Don't make it a moment where it's like, oh my gosh, her makeup was so beautiful. You instead want them to be like, oh my gosh, she was so beautiful, right? Like your inside energy and what, copper boom. Oh yeah, Lanice, you get it, right? But you want it to be like your, the beauty inside of you coming out because you feel confident in your first impression makeup. So the makeup is like a tool. It's a vehicle for you to be able to shine, not for people to be like, gosh, her makeup was so gorgeous, but I'll never hire her for this position. Or like, her makeup was so lovely, but she's not right for my kid. I don't know why I've watched a lot of reality television recently. I'm kind of stuck in like all these moments where like people meet the parents and the parents are judgmental. Okay, gonna curl lashes, we're gonna put on some mascara, and then we're going to find a lip. And again, the lip Doesn't have to be really intense. And in fact, I prefer it to be something really, really simple. Because far too often, people are like, this is my moment. Y'all know I love a bold, I love a bold lip. I do. This is not your chance to experiment. If you typically don't wear red, if red is not your signature color, today's not the day to choose red. Just don't do it. Don't. This is not your chance to branch out and be like, I'm gonna leave them. No, don't leave them being like, oh my gosh. Was that the woman with the lipstick on her teeth? Yeah, I remember her. Not cute. Not cute. Okay. I have been recently doing my bottom mascara first. I don't know what happened that I did this one day, but I did. I don't remember what inspired it, but I did my bottom mascara one day, like a couple weeks ago. Did it first. And then I was so impressed with my. I'm more impressed by my bottom lashes than my top lashes. It's a personal thing. And so once I saw my bottom lashes like showing out, I was like, that's really, really good. Which means my top lashes now just need to like come to the party. And I found that they did. They showed up. Once those bottom lashes were in formation, thanks Beyonce, then the top lashes were ready to do their job as well. So now I do my bottom lashes first. And it's a significant difference. Look, do you see that? Look at that. It's so pretty. Makes such a difference. And this is why you don't have to go with black eyeliner. Like your copper, your bronze, your brown, whatever more subtle eyeliner you use. Your mascara is going to do the job of emphasizing your lashes, and then your eyeliner just like pumps them up a little bit more. You know what I mean? Like just a oof, a little something. I'm going to let the bottom dry. I'm going to move on to lipstick, and then we'll do top mascara. Ba ba boom. Yeah, you know it's just so like, does it. Okay, I've talked about Clinique lipstick many a time. I can't get enough. They're so good. And these in particular are the Even Better Pop Lip Color Foundation. It's adorable that they call it, words. It is adorable that they call them that. And I have number 14 and nestled number 17 in Rumi. And I'm gonna show you both colors swatched on my hand. And I'm gonna recommend that you do this. This makes a huge difference. I've been saying this for a while. It might be that I say it in 85 Beauty Society, but not on these videos. So if you aren't in the private Facebook group for 85 Beauty Society, it's free. Just go join. And then I hop in like once a week, sometimes more, and I just do extra videos. But swatching color should be a regular part of your getting ready experience if you're using something new, so that you can tell before you screw it up on your face whether or not it's what you want. So here I am. This one is Woo Me. This one's Nestled. And looking, not in my mirror, but in the camera, because let's say that this is like my video interview, I can see this has too much pink in it. This with my eyeliner or my eyeshadow, it's not in alignment. They're competing for attention. This one, however, it's a little bit darker, it's a little bit deeper, right? It's a little bit more of a, hey, do you see me? However, it lines up, like it works in terms of the color. The color, it's harmonious. So I'm gonna go with this one. That's how you choose. Don't make it more complicated. Swatch it on your hand and see what it looks like. Do the test. Okay, so Woo Me is the color of choice. And I already put lip balm on, as I always do. So we're just gonna blot the excess off. And straight from the tube. These are like in terms of texture, they're like a cream. They are not matte. They're not shiny. They're just perfect. Is that fair to say? Because they are. They're so good. Okay. Top mascara. Do not stab yourself in the eye. I did that last week. Oh, God, it hurts so bad. And then I was with my niece the other day. No, we were on video. I felt like I was with her. And I was with her, but not at this moment. And she was putting on like a lash serum or something. And I saw the moment. I was like, did you just stab yourself in the eye? And she's like, yeah. I was like, I'm sorry, babe. That hurts so bad. I know. She's like, it really hurts. I was like, I know, hon. I'm so sorry. It's a terrible feeling. Like you just, especially because you did it to yourself. You're like, what just happened? It's so awful. Oh, I'm supposed to wait like 30 seconds before I put this part on. So I'll just do a little dance to the music in my head that I can't play because Facebook will take my music down. That happened last time and it was really annoying. It's about 30 seconds. I mean, it's not. I know that it's not, but I want mascara on right now. Oh, that happened. You see that? Don't freak out. Let it dry. Straight up. Just let it dry, and then you'll come back with a Q-tip and fix it. It'll smudge off a lot. It'll actually kind of flake off a lot easier than if you try to smudge it off now when it's wet, because it will end up instead smearing. And then you'll have to fix your concealer, and it's a whole thing. And a little smudge of mascara, like if it gets kind of on your eyelid, like near your eyeliner, I tend to just kind of smudge that in with a little brush because it gives it a little extra eyeliner look. Like I think we're a little too worried about looking super perfect. Come on, like, it's all good. Okay, so one little, oh, I'm dropping things. Just like that. And we're done. So I feel very, it's not that I want to look natural. My skin, I feel, looks really like clean and I was going to say bright, but like effervescent. Like I feel like I have a glow. My eyes look special, right? Like I do like a little color in my eyeshadow, a little color in my lips, nothing too intense or super bright. As an alternative, because I do like to give you options, if you felt like this was too much, you could instead, and I tell you guys about this all the time, I love a tinted lip balm. You could do, this is by Physician's Formula. This is gonna have a little more shine. And then you can just kind of pat it in with your finger. It'll take down the intense color and leave almost like a stain. But your lips, because it's a tinted balm, your lips are super moisturized. I actually like that better. And there's your look, just like that. All right, I hope you enjoyed it, as always. Leave comments. I answer all questions. I'm here to help. And I will talk to you super soon. Stay fabulous. Bye, y'all.